Welcome back to the Extremely Too Famous TV Show!
Yeah!
We did it!
We did it! And welcome to the docks here in Drammen. We have changed our studio location and today we are in Drammen.
Which is a city just outside of Oslo.
Yeah, it's the biggest growing city in Norway. So a lot of cool activities have started to happen here. The reason why we are in this particular spot right now is because in a little bit we are going to try something very cool and very new that is called flyboarding.
And probably very, very dangerous. I'm scared shitless.
You basically connect your feet to a water scooter and fly around in the air and it looks awesome and we're gonna try it out.
It's basically like, you know, when you see James Bond doing the jetpacks, it's literally the same
thing. We're gonna be James Bond in a
second. But we're doing it on the water, which is even cooler!
Yeah, and we are also going to check out another new sport that is called speed flying.
I don't even know what that is, which is totally awesome.
It's very fast. And then we are going to meet skateboarder Geir Myrvang and go spotting for nice shots to do skateboard photos with him and photographer Stian Evensen.
Yeah!
But first,
over to the news and the weather!
Welcome back to Fat News. I'm Adrian Evadesian, and here are your headlines. World-renowned peace activist has been rescued at sea in an attempt to run from Florida to Bermuda in a giant plastic hamster bubble. Norwegian windsurfer wins second place in world championships. And the X2 Extreme Sports Festival has officially announced the surf portion of their competition. Long-distance runner and peace activist Reza Baluchi's latest goal was to reach the Bermuda Triangle from Florida in a homemade hamster cage, but had to be rescued mid-sea by the U.S. Coast Guard due to exhaustion. His website stated the 1,662-kilometer trip was made in an attempt to raise money for children in need. All the best to the athlete. The extreme thrill of your dreams just may become a reality, with your help of course. That's right, inventor Aaron Wipizinski has developed an almost complete prototype of the wingboard. The wingboard is like a wakeboard, but in the sky. A rider stands atop a board attached with feet bindings, just like a wakeboard, and is towed behind a flying plane. The Wingboard project is currently on Kickstarter and accepting donations for the next 20 days. SpaceX, the privately owned spaceship company attempting to build a human colony on Mars by 2026 and headed by Tesla creator Elon Musk, has started already sending spaceships to space. Most recently, they've successfully sent mice and a 3D printer to the space station. A brand new video has gone viral this week. The short video features Scottish cyclist Danny McCaskill mountain biking down Coolin Ridge in his home island of the Island of Skye. As of right now, McCaskill's video has over 15.5 million views. Commenters attributed success to the beautiful scenery of Scotland and the video's up-close views of the dangerous ridgeline. And a big congratulations to Norwegian windsurfer Udo Brodholt, who just won second place in the World Windsurfing Championships. The humble 25-year-old attributes her success to good old-fashioned luck and strong winds. Norway's X2 Festivalen has just announced the surfing portion of the competition has been rescheduled. Last spring, organizers were disappointed by the poor weather conditions for surfing and therefore postponed it indefinitely until now. 48 surfers are registered for the competition, although the exact date depends on the weather. Stay tuned to your Fat News to find out. I'm Adrian Avedisian with the news. Over to Leal with the weather.
Welcome to the Fat Stone Weather. The season is bringing insane weather across the world. Baja California, for example, was ravaged by a Category 4 hurricane named Odile. Coming in from the Pacific, this typhoon brought winds of 209 to 251 miles an hour battering the coast. Currently, Hurricane Simon, The eighth hurricane of the season is bringing another threat to the Baja Peninsula. As you can see, Category 4 hurricanes bring extremely intense weather anywhere they come. The other side of the Pacific is getting battered by cyclones too, the most recent being Fanfan. The typhoon made landfall on October 6th with winds up to 180 kilometers an hour. The storm is expected to deposit 100 millimeters of water in Tokyo over a 24-hour period, according to the Transport Ministry. Thousands have lost power, and Japan's two biggest airlines have canceled flights until further notice. Across the world, from the southwest of the United States to Pakistan, thousands of people are being displaced by their homes from flooding, and the extreme weather season is just getting started. While it's important to discuss extreme weather on a channel known for extreme things, we are broadcasting from Norway, which has a more ideal image of what fall should look like. This means beautiful colors across the landscape. Greens are turning into oranges, yellows, and reds. But did you ever stop to think why? That's good, because I'm about to tell you. Plants have found many different ways of getting through the harsh days of winter. Without plenty of sunlight and water, deciduous plants stop making food in the fall. The chlorophyll, or the green color, reveals yellow colors that were there all summer long, but were just covered up by the green. Let me explain with our fall simulator. Yellow colors are made from xanthophyll. Orange colors are made from carotene. The red colors come from pigments that are known as antioxidants. In some plants, though, these are caused by glucose trapped in the plant. The brightest colors are seen in the late fall when the season is cool and dry. As the season gets colder and darker, those colors fade away and eventually the leaves fall, giving autumn its pseudonym, fall. And now you know. I'm Lael Hasrouni and this was your Fat Stone Weather. Back to you, boys.
Yeah, so we're now down at the dock, checking out some of the equipment that we're going to try out in a little bit.
Here you see there's some shoes attached to a little mini platform, attached to what looks like a fire turnout hose. And then they're going to hook this one into this one here, I think. And the power from this one is gonna
shoot water through this cable and in here and out from the legs and make you elevate. That's literally what's gonna happen. And you might have noticed that it's fall in Norway now, meaning that the water temperature is pretty much like it is during winter time anywhere else in the world.
Yeah, it could get pretty cold. But we are still waiting for the professionals who are going to show us how to do this, because we don't really know, although it seems like we have a lot of
experience knowledge.
But first of all, we're going to check out some guys doing speed fly.
Yeah, that's cool.
Okay, cool.
I mean, like when you have your own like extreme sports TV talk show on a TV, of course you have to, there's a lot of like things that you have to do, and I'm pretty much down with like a lot of extreme sports, you know, like a lot of them are just like guts involved, like jumping out of a plane, I can do that and stuff. So Matias just told me like, oh, let's get up early on Friday and we go and like we do some extreme sports, it's gonna be fun. And he wanted to keep it as a surprise for me what we were actually going to do. And then I come down here and we're gonna do this fucking crazy ass super dangerous water sport thing, and I'm not sure, like I don't even think it's fair, because Matias knows how much I suck in the water. Like he knows, like he took me up to his family mansion up in Lofoten this summer and he had me try to water ski in front of his entire family, and it was just humiliating. I was just trying so hard, humiliation after humiliation. So I don't know, maybe this is some kind of like revenge thing where Matias is like, oh, let's go out in the water and so that our fans can see how much better than I am than you are in the water or something like that. I don't know, man, like, I don't know, like, I'm fucking terrified. I don't know, like, I literally slept 2 hours, get woken up, I have to thrown out in this freezing water to do something that is A, very dangerous, and B, there's no way in hell that I can actually master this sport. But I'm gonna give it a shot. For you, my fans, everything for you.
Now when me and Jørgen have our own TV show on an extreme sport TV channel, I figured it was cool that we should go and try some extreme sports. So I found this cool sport on the internet. It's called flyboarding, which is the one we're gonna try now. And I thought it would be cool for Jørgen because last in the summer we tried water skiing and he couldn't actually do it, so I thought maybe this would be easier. And because I'm sure he felt really bad after not being able to water ski, so maybe this would help his confidence. So I thought it was going to be like really, really good idea, but when we come here he's like, no, it's dangerous. I don't know if it's dangerous. It seems totally safe on the internet, so I don't know.
I don't quite know how the equipment works, so we thought we should just go and ask some of the experts that actually owns all this equipment from jettrade.no.
Jettrade.no is where the experts are at. We gotta go get some tips. You're one of the experts on flyboard here in Norway. Is that right?
Yeah, I'm the starter of it. We started with it in 2012 with the flyboard
Oh, so
equipment.
So you've done it for a couple of years?
Yeah, a couple of years, yeah.
Okay, and you sell it or?
Yeah, we sell it, we do rentals, and we even attend in the World Cup 2 times. And it's
You've been in the World Cup?
Yeah.
They have competitions for this stuff?
Yeah, they get competitions.
Cool, cool.
Is it difficult?
Oh, I would say that the level of the riders now is really getting...
Yeah?
They're getting good, yeah. The first years, everybody was watching each other to, learn tricks, to see what's in the back. So now we have triple flips and huge dolphins, like tornadoes, like twisting up and go double flips.
Is it dangerous?
Of course it's dangerous. You can kill yourself. It's a hose. It's a lot of water. It's quick. And if you don't do it the right way, you can even hit the ski, and then you smash your brain.
Okay, yeah. We gotta be careful here, we understand. We've been checking out the equipment a little bit, the one that's down on the docks. Do we need anything else?
Oh, we're gonna have some wetsuits on, yeah. 7mm. I think it's 14 degrees in the water.
Okay, cool, let's get ready.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Perfect. All right.
Thanks a lot.
Start for me.
Now it's getting real, Mattia.
Oh my god, this is a total new extreme sports for me, man. Good thing we have a professional who was in the World Cup here. How did it go in the World Cup, by the way?
The first one, 16th. There was 52 riders. Last year, I flipped the ski, and then I got disqualified in the qualifying.
Ah, okay. But
so it went like shit, but
2 years ago, you were amongst the 20 best in the world. That's cool.
Okay, let's do this.
Let's do it.
Do it.
Oh.
We are almost ready here to get into the water and try the flyboards. Carl, have you ever hurt yourself doing this sport?
I just broke my rib totally off for like 8-10 weeks ago. And there was one guy who broke his spine, his back. That was in the summer. He hit the ski. So
so we have to be careful.
You have to be careful. It's all about who is the instructor. Because okay. You are out there and you're flying. So the instructor has to watch you all the time and just put you down so you don't hit
so
the ski.
So it's sort of like a team sport.
It's a team sport.
I like it. Team sports are cool.
Yeah.
Okay. Are we ready? Should we do the...
Yeah.
Just
so,
show us the check.
So now when you... I can simulate with him. So we should start like this. Now you're on the board. And I would just hold here and I would push him forward and dive him into the water.
Yeah.
Okay. And he would be like this in the water now, right? And he's just waiting for the... For the thrust under his feet, and he will steer. He is like swimming. He's the one that's steering. I'm not steering anything. I'm just giving you the throttle. So when we come outside the dock there, you will like this, go like this. You break up with your hands like this. Now your body will start to turn vertical, and then you just bend your knees like this. So you will become here in this position. But
where will the water be now? Like here or?
Now the water are here.
Yeah.
Water are here, and you will be a little bit forward. As in, and forward, so you go forward in the water.
Okay.
Because then you don't have to struggle with the balance to keep the balance before you come up. So you always have a little bit push forward, and then you just... here comes the speed, and you just... Straight up, bang! Just, this is so easy in the water, you know, just doing this. Because I'm 19.
Important. The most important thing when you go from swimming to go to the elevation point, you have to get your body like this. And the most easiest way is to do bend your knees, because then your thrust will turn you and your hands will help turn you. So you just turn like this in the water. You see it from side and you are a little bit like this. And then you straight out.
Yeah, okay, we have to try this.
It doesn't make any
sense. Okay, sip your helmet and let's go do it.
Okay. Now they're checking the technique here. See the engine? Wow. Pretty cool.
Just gonna equip this one as well.
Okay, now we got the training. We've been told how to do it. So we're just gonna put on our helmets and get in the water and get ready. But while we do that, you guys can check out this video. We'll be right back.
Like, if you didn't know us now and you just came into the show right now, you might think that we're experts at this sport and we're all here to show off our sport. That is a matter of fact, not the truth.
At all.
We don't know shit, to be honest with you.
But the good thing is that our teacher, Mr. Carly, says that this is really easy, so it's gonna be pretty cool.
He also said that he almost died on it.
Yeah, I guess it depends which part of what he said you're willing to put focus on, you know?
Which part is actually easy? The flying up and down and crushing your head into something, or doing cool tricks and... I just wanted to finish.
Er det veldig mye blåst her, eller?
Nei.
Ok, gloves on! Yeah. Thumbs up!
Thumbs up!
High five! Let's fucking do it!
Oh my god!
Here's it! We go play!
That was so cool!
Wow. Yeah, you did
that
it!
You're sick.
After the book!
A lot of fun!
That was after the book. Up on the first try, a little bit overhang on your ass, down and up again, and then you did it, huh?
Yes, thank you so much.
Now he had this. He has this bad disease, it's called a knee disease.
Fear.
It's like you go dancing, but you can't do that on the flyboard, you know? You can, but you have to be professional.
Cool, but let's just heat up a little bit and then we'll see how you do it.
Now we have a break and we will fix the gear and then we will
bang down.
Now we'll check out Carl. So normally when you have people coming here to try the flyboard, what kind of guys are testing it?
Everyone, from old people to young people to...
What's the oldest guys you have?
65.
Woo. Cool. And but is it very popular for bachelor parties?
Many bachelor parties.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's the top.
Cool, because I was thinking now, like, this would be perfect for a bachelor party startup.
Yeah.
Is this the warm-up you do?
Yes.
Is it called yoga for flyboarders?
Yes.
Pretty cool special yoga moves here for the flyboarder guys.
To be very moving about in
yeah.
That position, yeah.
To be warm and flexible.
It's
this is the move.
So this is how you throw the energy.
Cool.
The energy.
Shit's getting real. Carl is testing his professional equipment.
He's got a remote control for the throttle.
I'm expecting some pretty crazy tricks there.
I hope he does the tornado.
Of course he's gonna do the tornado.
Okay, so now we're gonna see the potential of this sport. I'm kind of glad we went first and he went after, otherwise I would have probably felt that I sucked at this. Now I feel, still now, I feel that I'm pretty good at it.
Yeah, me too. I was doing pretty good.
It's one of the many sports that I master.
True. A sport that me and Jørgen don't master so much is skateboarding.
And before we check out how Carl is handling his flyboard, we're going to go hunting for some epic spots. This is what skateboarders do when they're going to do some photography of skateboard tricks. They go to find a special location and then they try to nail a trick there. And this time we're going with skater Geir Myrvang and photographer Stian Evensen hunting for photography spots for skateboard pictures in the Lillestrøm area. Boom.
Jeg heter Stian Seim Evensen, og I dag jeg I hvert fall skatefotograf. Vi skal ta bildet årets første mission med Geir, som kommer der. Han ja, klar, ser det ut sånn.
Hallo. Leroy.
Hei, gutta.
Lenge siden.
Hei, Leroy.
Jeg heter Geir Myrvang. Min jobb på denne missionen her vel strengt at å stå for skatinga, på en måte. Prøve å få noe gjort.
Vi håper på å komme oss opp på et tak på Strømmen, som vi har drømt om I 2 år nå, egentlig. Men, så det må gjøres på en søndag, for det ikke veldig tillatt, tror jeg. Vi får se hvordan det går. Jeg har ikke sett det helt enda, men jeg har fått MMS av både Geir og av Stian, som driver sjappa her. Med at det her ser bra ut, så jeg tror det kan bli kult. Hvis det funker og vi kommer oss opp, så får vi tidenes bilde.
Ja. Jeg gleder meg. Det er sånn der greie du bare kjører på de hver eneste dag, liksom. I løpet av bare ser på, så bare faktisk, det der burde du få til. Det der burde du gå, men det mange variabler, da. Det ingen som har vært på taket nå, så det ingen som vet på en måte om det mulig I det hele tatt. Det kan være helt umulig, og det kan være god drit, egentlig.
Shit, altså, jeg så det taket for mange år siden og tenkte, faen, det der mulig at det går an å gjøre, liksom. Altså, jeg blitt så gammel og tjukk og pensjonert at jeg har ikke baller til å gjøre det, men Geir har det. Så, det kan gå, og hvis det går, så det jævlig rått. Men jeg ikke 100% sikker at det går. Det mye som skal stemme nå. Du skal klare å komme opp på taket uten at det kommer en hel haug med vektere, først og fremst. Og at ingen ringer snuten. Men det jo søndag, så det jo liksom den ene dagen det går an å gjøre det. Men det kan gå, men det faen meg ganske rått, altså. Det krever litt baller. Du kan gå skikkelig på trynet. Så det skal bli interessant. Da må jeg inn og hente brevet
mitt. Men jeg har trua, ja. Det alltid kult å være ute med Stian og Stian. Da blir det alltid bra stemning, og da får man alltid til ting, uansett. Så det blir kult, det.
Nei, vi skal pusse opp utingen litt, så tenkte vi må ha noen nye bilder på vegga. Og gjerne noe fra nærområdet her, da.
Jeg skal hette en evighet, sikkert. Jeg ikke, 15 år eller noe sånt nå. Bare, jeg synes skating helt lattelig morsomt. Og det vel egentlig derfor jeg har holdt på med det hele tiden. Så det det der med, jeg liker mye mer det kreative konseptet, det å finne nye spots og gjøre ting med ting som ikke egentlig burde gå an. Det litt gøy, da. Da det kult å ha et crew rundt seg som på en måte tror på det samme greiene. Da det gjennomførbart. Så jeg tror, jeg vet ikke, det sånn jeg trives med skating I hvert fall.
Stian, som vår eminente fotograf, som bruker jeg som filmsjef på Adidas også. Vi bruker alltid Stian, for han også fotograf.
Vi skal ta bilder, rett og slett, med Geir. Dagens mission.
Light in the spot, så liksom
Altså, vi bruker sikkert mer tid på det enn faktisk å skate.
Ja,
I hvert fall vi som liker det på en måte.
Tror jeg faktisk gjør det. Det mange som kan bare dra til Frognerparken og så være der og skate hele dagen. Jeg synes det blir litt boring da. Jeg liker å farte litt rundt og finne andre ting å skate på. Så, ja, det en veldig stor del av skatingen, en spotjakt da. Jeg drømmer jo alltid om å finne liksom, det perfekte spottet. Man ser på seg sånne ting I huet, sånn alt tenker på bunnen som ser Frogner. Det hender faktisk man finner.
Ja, uten å måtte reise uten oss.
Ja.
Gleder meg veldig. Nå vi på spotten. Opp der. Planen nå at Stian skal finne ut hvor han skal ta bilden. Så må han gjøre seg klar, og så driver Stian på å prøve å finne ut hvordan jeg skal komme meg opp dit. Så når Stian da jeg klar for å ta bildet, og vi gjør oss klare, så skal jeg shimmy meg opp dit. Håper for all del at det ser like bra ut der oppe fra, som der nede. Jeg har ingen anelse om hvordan overgangen til den andre taket der er, i det hele tatt. Så da er det bare å klatre opp, gjøre seg klar, gå for gull.
Jeg tror man var helt bak.
Jeg tror jeg bare rammer inn den bua der, taket der, så får med. Men hvis jeg går litt sånn her, så får jeg kanskje himmelen mer bak, ja. Men den blir her. Nei, jeg tror det lar seg gjøre, altså. Ikke noe blitser, ingenting, bare rett på sak. Ikke noe minst mulig stress, tror jeg. Det er den kanten, du ser jo buetaket som buer seg. Og så er det en sånn liten kant ved de der boblevinduene.
Okay.
Den lille kanten her kan du jo grinde. Eller gjøre noe på, så lander du i taket igjen før det flates ut der. Så det er ideen. Så jeg må starte liksom i der taket buer seg. Og så komme opp på curben et eller annet sted. Og så forhåpentligvis enten poppe helt ut i flat, eller lande i banken og sånn det.
Ja, Geir er jo helt rå. Han er veldig god til å skate, det er en ting. En annen ting så har han liksom veldig sånn... Han har mye guts, han tør å gjøre sånne ting som det her, og... Han har ikke noe sånn der... Han er ikke så fisefin på ting. Han trenger ikke ha verdens beste underlag, og... Trenger ikke være verdens lengste run-up eller landing eller sånne ting, så det er... Han er veldig... Hva heter han? Han er veldig flink til å tilpasse seg spots. Og veldig flink til å skate alt mulig. Og det er fordelen når det kommer til sånne ting som dette. Så det er kjempebra fyr å ha med seg ut, sånn sett. For han klager veldig lite på spotsa av underlaget. Og da er det alltid mye mer motiverende å få gjort ting.
Nei, jeg pleier å være flere, men jeg liker egentlig best å være med at det er en som er veldig dedikert og 100% klar for å gjøre akkurat det vi gjør nå. Men det er jo bare kult om jeg er et helt crew også. Det er ikke alltid liksom det viktigste, det er ikke alltid bare å få et bilde, men å ha en kul dag ute med skating. For hvis du bare er ute for å ta et kult bilde, så blir det ikke skating lenger. Men det her må jo bli bra, ellers så kan jeg legge opp, tror jeg.
Dette her er liksom... ordentlig street skating. Skating som absolutt ikke er lagd for å skates på. Så det er jo den kuleste delen av skating, mener jeg. Skating er veldig liksom drevet av liksom hyper da, motor og sånne ting. Men det er liksom rom for individualisme da, i skating også. Og det, så selv om det er mye av de der... Hva skal jeg si? Dylan Reader kidsa om dagen, så er det også rom for individualisme da, og andre typer skating. Det er helt klart. Andre typer stiler og sånn. Det er ikke alle som følger bølgene, og det er litt kult. Det kule med Geir er at han følger aldri noen bølger da, eller noen trender. Det er liksom... Han hadde alltid gått sin egen vei, og alltid de skaterne... Alltid hadde mest respekt for de skaterne som ikke har latt seg styre av ting. Som bare har gått sin egen vei og ikke brydd seg så mye om trender og hyper. Det er jo... Det finnes jo noen legendariske skater i Norge som faller inn under den kategorien der, og det er de man alltid har sett opp til.
Hva tror du? Dette blir så bra!
Hadde vi spurt om lov, så hadde vi sikkert aldri fått lov. Så det er vel livsmotto, det er ikke det, når jeg skater, at det er alltid mye lettere å få tilgivelse enn tillatelse. Men vi fant faktisk en vei på baksiden her, som var en trapp opp til taket, som var helt usikret, og alt var helt åpent. Så da er det liksom... Hva skal de si liksom? Det er jo ikke innbrudd når det bare står åpent, er det da. Så jeg tror det skal være litt sånn semi innenfor i hvert fall. Det tror jeg skal være.
De skal jobbe jævlig hardt for å få meg ned, for å si det sånn.
Ja. Det er veldig greit i Norge at politiet er vektere liksom stort sett sånn helt ordentlig. De har ganske mye begrensning på hva de faktisk har lov til å gjøre da. Men stort sett så er de sånn, er de greie liksom. Hadde de gjort dette her i USA, så hadde de jo kommet med helikopter og 20 biler og skutt deg ned fra taket, liksom. Men det skjer ikke her. Forhåpentligvis. Bakke i bordet.
Mange bord.
Jeg tror det skal gå greit. Ja.
Som regel så begynner jeg med å spørre hva skateren skal gjøre. Så finner vi ut hvordan viser trikset best, og så må jeg finne et utsnitt som viser scenery og spotten på en god måte. Så det her har ikke så mye valg egentlig.
Det er litt forskjellige triks som ser bra ut på forskjellige spots da.
Jeg usikker om jeg skal gjøre 50 eller 5. 50-50 er ganske mye greier å ha med å gjøre enn 5. Men 5 ser sykt mye bedre ut på bildet. Det er liksom 50-50 er veldig statisk. 5 er sykt dynamisk triks i forhold. Så må man bare gjør som sjefen sier, sikkert. Jeg lover å være litt nervøs.
Ja. Tror jeg det blir så archy-fartsy at det blir svart-hvit i dag? Det blir mye cleanere med svart-hvit, tror jeg. Ja, jeg tror det blir svart-hvit.
Er du klar? Ja. Er du sikker?
Ja.
God tur. Det blir bra, takk.
Kjører konkurranser så er du på en bane, alle andre skater, det er bare det er mange andre ting å tenke på. Så kan man sette sammen et run og styr og stell. Her skal man få med... Man skal bare ninja seg opp til et eller annet sted. Altså det er så annerledes, så det her er det som er gøy. Det her, da, ja, hvis du vinner en contest da, så er det kjempekult i... Ja, 3 uker til neste contest, liksom. Eller ja, folk husker det, det er ja faen han vinner mye contest, det er fett. Men det her da, hvis du får det her bildet, det er et, pass på det, helt rått på en måte print, du kan få det på trykk, folk skjønner, det er unikt da, ikke sant? Det er ingen andre som kommer til å gjøre det her, for det er komplett fucking idioti. Det er fint. Litt nervøs, skal man ærlig innrømme si man er. Det her er litt drøyere, men det er egentlig sånn her vi driver med alltid. Merk at det er ikke låst her, sånn at da bryter vi oss ikke inn. Der står den døra åpen, så jeg ikke får gå for nærmere.
Point of no return. Det skal også bedre.
Litt kløllete, han kommer seg nok opp, men vi kan ikke bli med opp med kamera der, for det blir litt kløllete. Vi har ikke akkurat tillatelse til å gjøre dette.
Jeg er veldig fornøyd. Han ligger bedre med armene. Han var liksom så stille sist. Så det så ut som det så for lett ut. Men nå var han litt vridd, og da var det litt mer liv i bildet.
Ja, jeg er dritt fornøyd. Det gikk jo over all forventning.
Hvor lang tid tok det?
Nei, dette er ikke fort. Hvor lang tid brukte det? Kvarter eller sånn? Det hadde tatt mer tid enn det. Jeg trodde det skulle stå her timesvis, ja. Men Geir, ass. Jævlig bra. Lever faen meg opp. Nei, jeg er dritt for det. Det gikk mye lettere på greier enn jeg trodde du skulle. Ja, det var kult. Fløy da.
Det var helt ordentlig egentlig. Jeg kom inn mye mer skjult enn andre enden, så det var fint. Kom opp og fikk triksa litt til, så det var fett. Det var kjempetrivelig. Det var litt uvant at det var så mykt, og så waxa jeg den tingen alt for mye. Så den ble psyko-glatt. Det var mye bra tratt. Det var pain. Ja, det var sjukt pain. Den var møkket også.
Det var veldig mektig. Første forsøk jeg bommet, så bare skjønte jeg ingenting. Jeg var svart overalt. Så. Det var kult. Stokka på å se resultatet.
Ja, vi stokka på
det. Egentlig bare gøy å få gjest ut.
Faen, det var jo for lett det her da.
Ja, det var
ja, det var fett det.
To år har vi snakket om det her.
To år siden vi begynte å snakke om det, siden vi fant det spottet her og begynte å snakke om det.
Det her ble for rått. Ja.
Så når du tok der, når du ikke hadde armen ut,
ja.
Det var jo genialt at du bestemte deg for å gå til fakey på den der, for da fikk du,
fikk
du den twitchen i armene som gjorde at du...
Så rått.
Det er brukbart.
Ja, det ser dødsbart.
Ja, ja, ja. Konge.
Ja, det bildet her, det skal blåses opp, og så skal det på veggen i butikken. For nå pusser jeg butikken litt, da trenger jeg noen nye bilder, for nå har vi hatt veldig mye kule bilder hengende lenge, men det er bilder som alle har sett nå, så vi trenger noe helt nytt. Ny sommer og ny slappe. Litt. Ny pynt på veggen.
I mean, I think you can bring out the whiskey and cigars, man. We just flew, Matias.
Oh my god, that was so cool. What do you think?
I mean, I was kind of terrified first, and when I got in the water, it was fucking freezing. But it was so much easier than I thought it was going to be. And the learning curve is really steep, and it only gets more and more fun when you figure out how to fly.
It was almost as easy as it looked on TV, but... I didn't actually do any tricks, but...
You tried though, you tried.
I tried to do a trick, I tried to do the dolphin.
I tried another trick, which I'm not sure if qualifies as a trick, but I actually flew over the scooter, or the water jet. I was kind of like, my trick was to try to not land on the water scooter, which is like the only hard item around all the soft water.
And you made it, you survived. High five, bro. We fucking flew.
I not only survived, I feel like a richer and more complete human being. I mastered another element, the air.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. And for all of you guys who are interested in trying a flyboard, just contact Carl at flyboard.no. He's really cool.
Yeah,
and will... we're going to check him out, how he's going to do it right now, or in any second.
Yeah, he's just literally just coming now, so.
Yeah. Do you need us to help you push you, or you know how to do it alone?
I will try.
You'll try? If you need a push, just let us know.
How was it again?
Now you have to be pushed.
Am I supposed to push this one?
Yeah. I don't know, actually. Don't... maybe not. Whoa!
What happens now?
Whoa!
Just give it full throttle!
Can you start from there? I don't even know if that's...
Oh my god.
Oh my god!
He proved that you don't really have to get wet in this sport.
Shit, he just started from land! He's probably one of the best in Norway in this sport. Oh my god, he doesn't even need to have a person on the scooter.
super fun.
Woo! Superstar!
You don't really have to get wet either.
No, you don't. But what the fuck? My body is so slow. I can feel the hose. Oh!
Wow, that was amazing, man.
That was the coolest thing I've seen after, like, people wingsuiting and shit.
But it was not good driving. It was not smooth. No? It was totally ridiculous.
The last drive of the season, maybe, for you. No, it's not?
We have to practice every day now till the championship.
What? When's the championship?
4th to 6th of December.
Whoa, they do championships in this sport in December? Ah, okay.
It was in Qatar the 2 last years. Now it's going to be in...
Yeah, the Arabs must love this.
So then you're going to be competing against the Prince of Dubai?
I don't think he will compete, actually.
So now that you've been practicing here in the 14 degrees water, is this going to give you an advantage when you come down to Dubai?
Probably not. And this is fresh water as well. So when we get to Dubai, it's very salty. It's really ripping your eyes out.
Ah, it's a difference.
So that's what helped me in Qatar last year, was that it was too salty. I went in a dolphin, I came up, couldn't see anything, so I was just riding, did a tornado backflip, and again did a backflip, and I couldn't see that the hose was going into the ski, and it flipped the ski.
So you did a double black backflip without seeing, almost?
No, not a double backflip, a single, but a tornado. All right. 360 backflip.
So this year maybe you should go down to Dubai, get used to the salty water first.
Yeah,
a little.
Yeah, I will.
And then represent Norway.
I would prefer a little bit of training. 2 or 3 days training, and then 2 or 3 days relaxing. Building up the energy, and then go competition.
Go and destroy. Competing.
Yeah, go destroy. Yeah.
We've seen you. We know what you're good for. Good luck.
Thank you.
I hope you get a medal.
I hope so. Probably today, maybe by the top 20. But I go for the top 10.
Cool. Yeah. But yeah, cool. Thank you so much. We had a great lot of fun here.
Yeah, it was.
We go.
Yeah! That was it for this time.
Great.
Check us out next time.